Just before 4 p.m., officers of the Northwest District responded to a report of a personal injury accident where a vehicle had went inside of a vehicle of a building. Those officers, as well as our partners from the Pike Township Fire Department, they also responded and were able to secure the scene. As you can tell behind me, this is an active investigation. I can tell you that there were six victims that were transported to various hospitals. At this time, we're able to say there are non-life-threatening injuries. And so our certified accident investigators, they're on scene as well, too, actually working this investigation. So we will be out here for some time, and I will take questions. However, it's still early on in the investigation, so any information that I do not have, I'll be able to update you or the news desk as the evening goes forth.
Do we know if these were employees or customers of the AT&T store that were injured?
I don't know the status of every victim. However, I can tell you that there were employees and citizens inside of that particular store. Don't know the number who was actually transported, but I can tell you that six individuals were transported with various injuries, however, non-life-threatening. I'm sorry.
Any other kids?
Too early to ascertain that at this point. They were just, as you can see, you hear the sirens behind me. This is still an active scene, as you can tell.
And the car that's in there, was it parked outside the building originally, or how
to,
did...
To my understanding, that vehicle was parked outside of the business. For whatever reason, unfortunately, I'm not sure if the driver, if their foot slipped or if it was just driver error. That will come out as the investigation continues.
But it was parked.
Run from the scene?
To my knowledge, the driver did leave the scene. That particular driver has been taken into custody. We're not calling that driver a suspect at this point, just a person of interest.
And what do we know about the driver, male, female?
To my knowledge, the driver is a female. I'm not quite sure of the age at this point either.
Who called 911?
And there were various 911 calls that came in. As you can imagine, whenever something like this happens, this is a heavily traveled area, and so when something like this happened, you see this, there were numerous 911 calls reported to our dispatch center, as well as from inside of the store, as well as citizens just driving by.
We don't know if any of those victims were actually outside the store. They were all inside
To preliminary information suggests that they were all inside of the store. Our friends from the fire department, they'll be here for a while trying to help with the structure, as you can imagine. I'm sure that there will be some sort of building inspector or whatnot that will respond. If you can avoid this particular parking lot, that'd be great so that our medical personnel can go back and forth.
You said non-life-threatening injuries.
That is correct. That's correct.